Hello everyone, and welcome to this new Dota Underlords video. So today we're going to be looking at part 5 of the big update previews. This time we've got introduced to some new game modes. So for example here, we're looking at the duos mode. Find a partner, party up, and battle against several other gangs. So this is very cool for a multitude of reasons. First of all, this was one of the most requested, most hyped up features of this game. After, you know, a similar mode appeared in Dota Auto Chess, people were really enjoying it, and everyone was hoping that it would make it to this game as well. And so it did, it looks like. So, the first of all, a very interesting thing here, it says battle against 7 other gangs, which means there will be a total of 8 gangs of 2 players per game. This means that the total amount of players per lobby is going to be 16, so that's twice as much as normal. So what this could result in is if the pool of heroes is exactly the same, this could mean that we would be a lot tighter on the hero pool. So like the pool would deplete a lot quicker. So we are going to have to wait and see how that plays out. It's very interesting because maybe because of that, they will change the pool and specifically for the duos, increase it a bit further. So yeah, team up with your partner in crime and battle against 7 other gangs to be the last duo standing. Yeah, so another other cool features includes the sharing and trading. So you can send your heroes and your gold to another player. So while Dota Auto Chess did have the whole hero sharing thing, it did not have the gold sharing. So it's very interesting that they decided to include it here. Basically Warcraft 3 style, you know? When you were playing Warcraft 3 in a lot of custom games, as well as in vanilla, you had this thing where you could just, you know, when your ally is in trouble, you could still send them some gold to bail them out. Very peculiar. And makes the whole thing even more exciting. Another important aspect that, well, comes from Dota Auto Chess as well is that the health pool is shared. So we're assuming we're, as a team, we're going to have 200 health total. But if it is depleted, both players are knocked out. While this could be dangerous, this also allows for some situations where, you know, one player is win-streaking while the other player is lose-streaking. Because if it's just one player from the duo that loses, it would mean that they have a much higher health percentage remaining. So the way winning and losing works, like it's said right here, teams face off in 2 individual battles against another duo with round damage added up from fights, from both fights. So, for example, you can win your fight and do some damage to the opposing team while your ally can lose a fight, and the opponent team will then do damage to you, your team. Yeah, so this could result in a situation where one player is win-streaking, the other player is lose-streaking, and it would basically mean the lose-streaking player could feel a lot more comfortable because they would have a much higher total health pool remaining. And yeah, I assume this also means that you could get knocked out crazy fast, just, you know, out of the blue. You know, normally, when people say one-shot range, you know, when you're gonna get knocked out, basically, if you lose once, it usually means something along the lines of 16 health or less. But in this case, it could mean, for example, 40, you know, 40 health could be one-shot range because, you know, you lose both fights, you take 20 damage from both, you're out. You're gonna have to be really careful for that one. Strategies are also another very interesting part of this whole thing, because since you're basically having to pick twice as many heroes from the pool as you normally do, it could mean that you could find 3 stars a lot easier. So it might stand to reason that a lot more players will, instead of leveling up, reroll at round 7 or 8 and find all the necessary pieces for both players. Everyone is excited for this new change. And I am, obviously I am as well. So there's even more reasons to get excited, in addition to the new heroes and new alliances. And the jail, of course, the jail is awesome. Never thought I'd say those words in my life, but yeah, jail is awesome. The other feature I'm really excited at for is freestyle mode, perhaps even more excited than the duo mode, because, you know, I don't really have any friends who currently play Underlords to actually play duo with. So in this mode, you have full control of the board and can create any scenario you can think of. Use it to explore army compositions or test new hypotheses. You can then share your design with friends and the community. So basically, this is going to be like a sandbox mode that most of the other games have, where you can do whatever you want. You can set up both sides of the board, put anything you want on them, any sorts of upgrades. Like you can see right now, we have, you know, on one side of the board, what looks like a bunch of bloodbounds and healers with Roshan, Potato, and Tomato. And on the other side of the board, we have what looks like six assassins, as well as a bunch of dark trolls from round 40. So yeah, basically you can put anything you want, and then you just press play, and they just go at each other and fight, and you find out what is stronger. So I am very excited for this feature because, you know, I love those sandbox modes where you can put anything against anything else, and, you know, see what happens. For example, you can put one strong unit on one side of the board and a whole bunch of other weak units on the other side, and then just have them duke it out, and then share it with everyone, I guess. It says, create. Quickly create any scenario you wish with a set of handy tools and options at your disposal, and then share. So share your encounters with your friends and community in the click of a single button. So that's very interesting here. It sounds kind of like this feature that Hearthstone has, where you can share your decks. So I guess what this means is basically you create two sides of the board, and then you just click share, and basically you have either a link or a code of sorts for that particular board setup that you just did. Then you give it to your friend, and your friend is like, huh, well, that's cool, you know? Who would have thought that to beat Roshan, you would need 10 gyrocopters or whatever? It's actually probably not going to work because, you know, Gyrocopter isn't strong enough to tank Roshan, but, you know, it was just an example, okay? As a creator, I am also even doubly so excited for this feature because, you know, when people play those sandbox modes, they always, you know, create something horrible, have things on the board horribly die, and then just laugh a lot. So that could also be a thing. This is truly going to be something to behold. And of course, as creators, you know, creating those, you know, hilarious montages, or just plain old experimenting on everything, is hopefully going to attract even more players to the community because they will see how fun all this experimenting feature is. So, this is our job as creators, right? To attract as many people into the community, and then the community growing even further, and basically everyone wins. The developers win because more players play the game, their game. It gets more exposure, the creators win because, you know, they get more money for creating stuff. And of course, the new members win because they get to enjoy all this awesomeness. So right there, we have Baby Tokoyami again, who says things like,
it's like dancing, but with more stabbing! Gah! Gah!
Thank you, Baby Tokoyami. Very cool. Very cool indeed. They say right here, we still have a few more days of previews, so come back tomorrow for more. So I'm assuming what this means is they will show some other features that currently haven't been shown, such as the namesake Underlords that everyone is also waiting for. And I think there might be some more features that we either haven't heard of yet, or maybe I just forgot about them. Forgot what they were. Anyway, that's going to be it for this video. If you're enjoying what you're seeing, consider liking, sharing, and subscribing. Also consider checking out other videos because I've made a video for every other preview as well. And I'm definitely looking to create more content related to Dota Underlords, especially when this big patch hits. So, yeah. Thank you for watching this one. And I'll see you in the next one. Goodbye, and take care, everybody.